Thank you for joining us on Off the Press and Plus TV Africa, where we bring you the major headlines from national dailies and we get into reviews and analysis with in-house guests. Joining me this morning for that will be social analyst Anihuyi Ayeni. Thank you, Anihuyi, for staying with us still.
Thank you. Thank you,
Benny. And we started straight with the Punch newspaper. The first headline making the rounds in the Punch is diesel kerosene price failed to drop despite oil crash. And that you find on page 24 in the Punch newspaper. Consulate compiles stranded Nigerians' names in America for evacuation. Gas shortage stalls 10,362 megawatts in 3 days. 2011 polls, Jonathan Knox ex-U.S. envoys rigging claims. And still in the Punch this morning, FCT, Lagos, Ogun communities ignore Buhari's lockdown order. Hunger won't allow stay-at-home Lagos residents. 36-year-old dies of as coronavirus figure jumps to 232. Don't bring Chinese doctors. NMA nurses wants the federal government. Still in the Punch, no plan to cancel Ondo LG polls. And Ekiti disinfects hospitals, market and schools. UITH probes prof over dead COVID-19 patient. And Airpeace delivers federal government medical supplies from Turkey. Lagos security guard neighbor arrested for defiling minors. And lastly, this morning in the Punch newspaper, Funke Akindele arrested for lockdown house party. FCT Lagos Ogun communities ignore Buhari's lockdown order. And amazingly, luckily, you and I were on our way to work at the same time today.
Yeah.
And there seemed to be a whole lot of people on the road.
On the road,
and
yes.
We begs the question, what exactly is going on here? Now, I for one thought when there was a news last week, cutting down on the lockdown, some people like essential services, like the pharmacy, the supermarket, and a few markets. I was of opinion that for these people to be open, they would need to be patronized by the people who are meant to be at home.
At home.
And so we seem to have a large number of people on our streets, on our road, cars flying the road. How do you react to this, Anihuyi?
My reaction would be that life still goes on. Some of these people have to go out, not because some of them have emergencies to deal with. Somebody might live in Agege, for example, somebody else is in Ajah, and they say your mother just fell down and she needs your attention immediately. That person is going to violate every single lockdown order you can ever imagine just to get to the mother. Life still goes on. It's just time for the government to also see and look into the society exactly what are the things going on. And this is where I feel that we should include all the churches and all the mosques that we have around. Because in every community in Lagos State, in every community in Nigeria, the way we live now, you have a church, you have a mosque. Let the government engage those people in the form of what exactly is happening. If you have a problem, go to the nearest church, go to the nearest mosque and report. Let government get daily updates on what exactly is going on so they feel the vibes of what people are going through. Putting people in lockdown without any forward plan of what happens during the lockdown, it will cause anarchy.
Yeah, but I'm just wondering, I mean, with the lockdown, it seems like a partial lockdown as it is right now in Lagos,
yeah,
with the movement of people around and with what the government is trying to achieve to curtail the further spread of this virus, are we not worsening the situation moving around with the number of people we see on our streets and on the roads?
Because some of those people who are coming out still don't have, well, they still don't believe.
Basic necessities?
Some of them have basic, okay. Well, basic necessities, Benny, we can argue basic necessity from today till tomorrow. There will always be, basic necessities will always be what they are. And people will always have what they have. But the thing, also, we need to start finding out the reasons why people are coming out. It's not just, okay, don't come out, don't go out. Why are you outside? What are you doing outside? By the time you hear from 10 people the reason why they are out, then you can now put put measures in place to address the issue that brings them outside.
Well, one of the issues they say is hunger.
Well, one
and like you all know around here, many people work daily to feed themselves. And so all of that is not in place right now. People can go out to fend for themselves. And so hunger could be a very valid reason for people to want to come out of the lockdown order.
This is a very good time. There's one of the things we beat ourselves up about a lot in Nigeria, and that is the lack of data, the lack of information. Yeah. Like I said before, this is a time to engage and really find out what is really bringing people out. On Friday, on our way home from work, we actually saw a vehicle, a Sienna, and it was private, and they had cooked food in their vehicle, and they were feeding people outside. And there were quite a number of people lined up to get food from them. They were feeding them real meals. So if people are saying that it's because of hunger, you have not been able to get food from here, I think with everything that is going on, there is quite a bit of food around the environment. Let's find out exactly why people are outside. And not just, yeah, people are out, they shouldn't be out. Why are they outside?
Yeah. Now, amazingly, someone who was supposed to be an ambassador, Funke Akindele, was arrested yesterday owing to the fact that she had a house party with lots of people inside. And it begs the question of responsibility,
yes,
and accountability of people, especially in the likes of Funke Akindele, who is seen as a public figure.
And what they say matters, where they say it matters. So it really shows that we really need to see more positive things coming out of through those type of things. It's really sad it happened. It's very sad to hear that it happened. That's all I can say about it.
All right, quickly, let's go to the Nation newspaper. This morning, first headline in the Nation newspaper, Akindele arrested, Naramali wanted for holding party. Weekend lashes federal government over handling of coronavirus. Oshun discharges patient, 109 returnees. And virus, 33 doctors, nurses in isolation after contacts. And also Pope holds Palm Sunday in empty basilica. This and more making the headlines in the Nation newspaper. Still, the Funke Akindele matter came up, and also weekend lashes federal government over handling of coronavirus. Now, you're a social analyst, and in your opinion, in your social opinion, I did ask that earlier on, do you think so much has been done by the federal government in curtailing the spread of this virus? And also getting people tested to actually ascertain the amount of people who are actually positive for this pandemic.
The coronavirus is something that is transmitted from one person to the other. All the people working on this coronavirus thing, they are also susceptible to actually testing positive for it. Like, for example, one of the news clips I read this morning actually said that the Prime Minister of the United Kingdom has been taken to hospital, Boris Johnson. And while he's positive, he's been attending. We keep blaming the federal government. They've done enough. He's a governor. I don't think this is a time to start telling somebody you've done less, you've not done enough. What has he himself done? My friend lives in Port Harcourt. Nobody's supposed to go into Port Harcourt, but she tells me that people go into Port Harcourt from Abia State through the waters. Let us take care of what we have to take care of. Let us be accountable for what we need to be accountable for. Let's go to the government with results and solutions. Let's go to them with the fact that, okay, sir, this is what I have been able to do. How can it be replicated by the next person to improve what is going on, rather than passing the buck and name calling?
Yeah, and we're even concerned right now, our caregivers, the first responders.
Yes.
We have about 33 doctors and nurses under surveillance right now and possibly scare in Lagos, in Lori, and also one other state, Benin. Now, it brings a question to mind, how protected are these first responders, our healthcare, in attending to people who might be suspected to be COVID-19 positive? If we're having 33 people, 33 medical doctors and nurses going under surveillance, it calls for worry about what protective measures and gears are in place in our hospitals.
That's the reason why we as individuals need to take seriously whatever the government says. Because right now, everything is not just the government that is saying it. This is what the World Health Organization recommends for everybody. So it's not like, now people say Nigeria likes to copy and paste. They say, oh, because Nigeria has seen UK do this, we are doing that. Let us be disciplined enough to follow what the World Health Organization says. Now, in terms of those in the front line and everything, do they have the necessary personal protective equipment that they can use? When you are in the hospital, I'm sure when they're taking care of patients, yes, they can remember to put the gloves, they can remember to put the mask. But at one time or the other, there's an emergency and all that is thrown away. That happens because you are in the front line, because you are dealing with an emergency. And so it actually brings home to the truth to us that this, what we are facing, is real. And those people who are actually doing, who are in the front line, are people like us. Are people like us. Yes. So whatever it is that we can do in our own way to make sure that we don't increase the numbers of what is happening, let us do it. Have our own personal self-discipline and governance to know that this is, I cannot do this, I cannot do that, because it will affect the other person negatively. Yeah.
Now, as it stands, from data gotten from the NCDC as of today, we have about 33 recovered. We have 5 deaths recorded and 232 cases. What does this say?
Increasing numbers.
And do you think in coming days we're still going to have more numbers? The numbers are going to increase.
When we have the health workers now, now showing the fact that they are susceptible to this. Some people are in isolation and they have not yet been tested. They are yet to be tested to find out whether they are positive or negative. I think, as much as I would not like to say so, I think the numbers will increase. And I feel that it will get to an extent whereby the numbers will start to drop soon. I really feel that it might start to drop soon, but I think it's still going to get to a place where the numbers will increase. Because remember, last week they did say they were able to trace 3,000, over 3,000 people, almost 4,000, that they have been able to trace. So out of all those people, we are still looking forward to another set of results in another set of 14 days, in another set of 5 days. So really, our prayer is that it doesn't get up to the thousands, but I think we are still going to see increasing numbers.
Now, but with the lockdown order being flagrantly disobeyed, I'm thinking the essence of the lockdown, again, which is to curtail the spread of the virus, might not be achieved with the amount of people roaming our streets, especially in Lagos, which happens to be the epicenter of this pandemic in Nigeria. What should the government agencies like the police people or the law enforcement agency be doing right now and not arresting citizens, which I've seen yesterday? I mean, that happened right in front of me. I'm like, okay, this is not why you guys are out here. Yeah. How are you meant to know why they're coming out? I mean, and if their reason for coming out is not valid enough, then I don't think arresting them and using your gun butt on them is the way to go about it. And so there's also going to be the aspect of, you know, human rights violation by the policemen who are meant to police the people. How do we go about this, handling all of this?
I think one of the things that we can also do is, like, for example, taking personal responsibility. Family, speak to your family members. Why do you need to go out? Brothers, sisters, speak to your neighbors. Speak to your friends. You don't need to go out, don't go out. If you don't need to go out, don't go out. Let us be accountable to one another. Hold each other accountable so that we can help support what the government needs to do. One of the hallmarks in health and safety is this: let not what I do jeopardize what everybody else is doing. Now, if we take personal responsibility, I don't need to go to that place, I don't need to go. So that when we have that kind of thing, and then we can, we see the effectiveness in the lockdown. Now, for example, then look at the issue of how many people are outside. Now, given that we have about 40 million people in Lagos State, I don't think the people outside are up to a million. I am not promoting the fact that they should be out, but in the midst of everybody else that obeys, you will always have people that disobey. There are not so many. That's what I'm saying. But let us take personal responsibility of what we do.
And lastly, we look at the Guardian newspaper this morning. Outrage over government move to invite Chinese doctors. It's insult to local health workers, sacrifice, says the Nigeria Medical Association, NAD, and Chinese Turkish medical supplies to arrive in Nigeria. COVID-19 lockdown stalls Palm Sunday procession. And that's much of it this morning in the Guardian newspaper. Outrage over government's move to invite Chinese doctors. I mean, should you think in the first place this should have ever come up for discussion?
No, I don't think so. Because in the first place, I, as an individual, in my opinion, we should not be taking anything from China. I'm sorry, but that is the way I feel about it. Because now the Chinese doctors are coming here for what? Over the weekend, it was trending in the news that the French said they wanted to test this vaccine on Africans. So what are they coming here for? To come and try some medication and some, I don't think. And the NMA has kicked against it, which is good. So I don't think the government should be allowing any Chinese doctors. We have doctors. We have competent people in Nigeria that can do this thing. Let's empower them to do what they need to do.
Yes. Anihuyi Ayeni, thank you very much for joining us on Off the Press and for your contribution.
Thank
you for staying with us. That's all we can take this morning on Off the Press, but do join us again same time tomorrow. This is Plus TV Africa, and I am Benny Ark. Good morning, and do stay with us.